Welcome back, my Daniacs. We're back from Great Dane Care. We hope that you all had a wonderful Labor Day weekend and were able to enjoy some time off with the friends and family while still staying safe. Now for today's video, we're going to be covering 11 different things that only a Great Dane parent would understand about Great Danes. Now by parent, I mean, you know, anybody who's a caretaker, a, you know, owner, who just in general spends a lot of time with Great Danes and really gets to know them really well, as opposed to people who might just kind of pass by them on a day-to-day basis and only get to understand a small sliver of what these gentle giants have to offer. Now, if you're brand new to the channel, my name is Zach and this is Gus and we're from GreatDaneCare.com. And it's our kind of mission to spread goodwill and information about Great Danes to improve their care and their lives of their families everywhere. So if this is something that resonates with you, make sure to subscribe down to our channel down below. Now for number one, to begin the list here, I'm gonna be talking about a Great Dane's giant heart. And I don't mean necessarily the physical larger size of their heart, but more so the fact that these dogs are just the biggest softies in terms of being very sweet and sensitive creatures. Now, while many dogs are more emotionally in tune with kind of what's going on around them, Great Danes in particular are very sensitive and responsive to kind of the feelings and the vibes that you give off. So you'll oftentimes find that if they get scolded for doing something wrong or chewing up a pair of shoes that they shouldn't have, which Gus, she swears she will never have done, if you were to scold them or kind of, you know, tell them they did a bad thing or they got in trouble, you'll oftentimes find they will kind of retreat and kind of, you know, be sad and sorrowful for not just a couple of minutes, but sometimes even a couple hours until you kind of come back and say, it's okay, we still love you, and all the things that kind of come around with that. So these dogs, you know, not only respond to, you know, the feedback that you give them, but they will also feed off your own emotional feelings. So if you're feeling down or sad, you oftentimes find that they want to come up and, you know, snuggle with you or spend some more time. And that leads into my second point about Great Danes, that unless you really spend a lot of time around them, you wouldn't really understand, but given their kind of large size here, it's surprising how much they like to cuddle and really consider themselves a lap dog. Wherever you are, as you know, the humans or the other members of the family, they want to be right there with you, oftentimes physically touching you, so that way they can kind of feel close and feel connected. And whether it's just for their own kind of, you know, emotional needs or wanting to be protective, they really are the biggest lap dogs out there. And if you check on Instagram and other kind of, you know, social postings, you'll see tons of funny pictures of Great Danes trying to get close to their humans and, you know, be in a space that's probably better suited to a 10-pound dog and not a 100-plus-pound dog. But all this boils down to the fact that they really are just the sweetest dogs who really just want to spend time around the people that they love. Now, coming up on number three in the list, this is a perfect transition because not only do they love spending time, you know, touching you and being close and being in your lap, where they realistically don't really fit beyond the age of, you know, 2 months old, Great Danes really just do not understand quite how large and how massive they are. And this applies not just to, you know, trying to cuddle in your lap or hop up into a chair with you, but also just going places. You'll find that they will oftentimes, you know, walk into some kind of tight corner or tight area, not realizing that they quite literally cannot turn around to get out of there, then trying to have to find a way to, you know, retrace their steps and back up, which almost feels like a semi-truck backing up at times, just because it is such a funny and awkward scenario to watch this happen. But also situations like if I'll be hanging out on the floor and the ground kind of playing with my young children, Gus will try to sneak down as low as she can to kind of sneak in there and be close with you. Or if you kind of have, like, you know, holes with your arm, she'll try to like fit her whole body through there just as a way to kind of engage and play. Once again, forgetting that she's no longer the 20-pound puppy that which she was at 8 weeks when she joined our family, but she's now a 150-pound, fully grown Great Dane. They just have no concept of quite how big they are. They just want to, once again, be close to the family to enjoy and spend time with you. Now for number four on the list is, we've got something that I think many pet owners really take for granted, and that is finding different pet accessories that fit your dog. So whether it be things like, you know, the collars that they wear, different clothes you might try to put on them in cold weather, anything when it comes to fitting a fully grown Great Dane, you really have a lot of limited options out there. So while many owners can just simply drive by your local pet store and find, you know, something, you'll have 20 some options off the rack to grab for your dog, when it comes to a Great Dane, you'll be lucky if you have one or two of a particular item that fits them. In many cases, you often have to order custom things off, whether it be Etsy or Amazon or some other online source, just because there aren't many things out there that are frankly made to fit a giant dog of this size. And this applies to, of course, specialty things like beds and crates as well. So something that, you know, people who are caring for a Great Dane full time really have to deal with on a day-to-day basis, and just do a little bit more planning, because you may not be able to find these types of items just at any pet store that you go to pick up. So for number five on the list, I've got something that I think is a real treat with Great Danes that I think most people, until you actually go up and pet them and spend a lot of time with both young and old Great Danes, you don't really appreciate. But that's how soft and velvety their fur actually can be. Now, like humans, there's always gonna be some variability in terms of how, you know, soft the different textures of your hair, but many Great Danes have a very kind of soft, velvety fur that, you know, isn't just something that sticks around when they're a puppy, but also extends up until they're older adults as well. And just the fine kind of soft nature of it is really a pleasure to kind of pet, just kind of feel how nice and soft they are. And unless you really have a Great Dane who just has a naturally just much coarser fur, or perhaps if they've gone, you know, a month or two and they just really need a bath and they're really dirty. Otherwise, they generally have very soft coats that many, many people are surprised when they come up to kind of pet your Great Dane, just how soft they really are. So I think that's a real treat, because they once again like to snuggle with you and spend so much time around you. It's great that you have kind of a nice soft velvety coat, you know, rubbing up against you at least. Now for number six on the list is something that, you know, every pet owner has to kind of deal with or make some kind of plans, and that's, you know, the human food that we leave out, knowing that oftentimes it has too much salt or sugar or other additives that can make our dogs potentially sick. You know, most dogs you can just simply push it to the back of a countertop and not have to worry about it at all, but our Great Danes, thanks to their large size and pretty intelligent nature in most cases, you have to make totally different plans to ensure that, you know, food that's left out on the counter, if your Great Dane is a food thief, you have to make totally different preparations to ensure that they can't get to this, just because we do want to avoid upsetting their belly or leading to diarrhea and other kind of bad issues like that. So things that are left out on the counter with a Great Dane, or with a different dog, cannot be done with a Great Dane. So you'll have to find a place to wrap them up and put them away inside the refrigerator, put them inside of cabinets. Basically anything that you could reach just on the counter yourself. You know, a Great Dane standing up on their hind legs could easily jump up and grab it as well. So until you've really experienced this, just the ability to hide and kind of keep your food out of sight, if your dog is the food thief type, something you'll just have to make some preparations for. Now, on the topic of feeding the Great Danes, and this leads into my next point here in terms of things that only a Great Dane parent would really understand, is the kind of care and planning that is often put around mealtimes for Great Danes. Now, the reason for this is because bloat is unfortunately something that occurs with a higher rate of occurrence with Great Danes. Many owners really try to take a lot of precaution around, you know, limiting the amount of play and activity both before and after meals, because that's believed to increase the potential of experiencing bloat. And none of us, absolutely none of us, want anything bad to happen to our Great Danes. So it's something that I find many owners are very careful about in planning. Whereas with other dogs, you know, that's still probably something that's taken into consideration, but probably not to the maniacal nature that many Great Dane kind of parents will apply to make sure that their dogs are doing whatever they can to kind of decrease that chance of experiencing a case of bloat, just because we love them so much and absolutely would not want anything to happen to them. For number eight on the list here, we're going to talk about something that's a little bit dirty, but once again, not something that you would really consider unless you've been a Great Dane parent and really spent some time caring for them, and that is that big dogs have big poops, and that's no surprise, but the bigger surprise here is that you have to really come up with some, you know, creative and unique approaches to making sure that you're able to pick up all this different poop around the yard and other areas to ensure that, you know, it's not killing the grass, your kids aren't running in there and stepping in the biggest pile of dog poop you've ever seen in your life. So getting oversized shovels and scoopers and kind of making this part of your weekly routine to go out there and get it cleaned up is really important. But also taking a step beyond that, when you go to the dog park or you go to the trails or you just really go anywhere out in public, you really need to make sure that you've planned in advance to carry your own dog poop bags, because the standard ones you might find at the dog park are gonna be these little itty bitty ones that are never gonna pick up the Great Dane's poop. So getting a kind of, you know, an XL or some larger variety to be able to handle that is something that every Great Dane parent really, you know, plans for, to ensure that they're quite literally not getting themselves into a messy situation when the time arises. Now for number nine on the list, many Great Danes are known for, you know, being droolers, kind of creating a little bit of a mess. Another area that many people don't actually realize is that the kind of eye boogers that come out, especially when they're younger puppies, can be pretty gross. And I think similar to kind of when they shake their heads and drool flies everywhere, The eye boogers can also get caked in the weirdest of places. Now, this isn't to say that, you know, they have some kind of disease or anything like that, but just the fact that this kind of eye gunk can build up, and while it is very quick and easy to wipe out, I think you'd be very surprised just how much it can accumulate. Much like they need to clean their ears on a weekly basis, keeping up with just kind of a, you know, just every so often kind of wiping some of this eye gunk out proactively is a great thing to do for the eye health of a Great Dane. All right, so for number 10 on our list here, and this is the second to last option, something that many dog owners really take for granted, I believe, until you've got a giant breed like a Great Dane, is that, you know, you'll be out on a walk somewhere and you'll see some little dog just kind of like jumping, going crazy, wild and crazy on the leash, you know, trying to drag the owner. But because they're so small, you know, the owner has no impact. They can just kind of keep holding the leash, ignore the bad behavior, and it's no big deal. For a Great Dane, that type of bad behavior is not only unacceptable, but it could actually lead to injury in these types of situations. So you'll have to be very diligent in terms of, you know, making sure that you properly train a Great Dane to walk nicely on a leash. So that way, if they see a bird or a squirrel or some other dog and they want to chase them, you know, if they wanted to, they could probably basically drag you down the street. So making sure that, you know, you don't take for granted, you know, the ease of walking a dog, and you really do put in time and practice into having them walk nicely and not respond poorly to these types of situations is something that every Great Dane owner, you know, really puts a lot of emphasis on from an early age. All right, so for number 11 on the list, and this is our last and final item, and I saved it for last because it's probably one of my personal favorites about a Great Dane. I talked in the beginning about their kind of, you know, sensitive and caring nature and liking to be lap dogs, but one thing that I absolutely love just so much about Great Danes is being able to get a hug from them. And now by hug, I don't mean, you know, standing up with their paws on your shoulder. Sure, that's cool, but I think it's a little bit dangerous at times. I mean, you know, sitting down, you know, if your dog's just kind of sitting, giving them a little hug and having them kind of hug you back just by leaning their head on you. It's one of the best feelings in the world to have a dog that's, you know, basically the size of a human kind of hugging you back, leaning into you for affection. It's just the sweetest thing. And while every pet owner can appreciate, you know, receiving affection back from their dog or their pets, with a Great Dane, when it's this much love kind of being, you know, directed back at you, it just feels amazing. So being able to appreciate and enjoy that with your Great Dane on a day-to-day basis and really not take it for granted, because no matter how long our dogs live, you know, it's never long enough, and at some point they will cross that golden rainbow onto the next life. But being able to appreciate them and love them every single day, I think, is really something that all of us should strive to enjoy more. So with that, we hope that you enjoyed this video about the 11 things that only Great Dane parents would understand. If you're a Great Dane parent yourself, we'd love it if you would kind of contribute some things that, you know, you feel like you really have learned and gotten to enjoy out of the Great Dane as a result of, you know, spending a lot of time with them. If you don't have a Great Dane yet, hopefully you found this video helpful. And until next time, stay Daney, my friends.